Hello. Hi.
Astronaut, what?
Hi.
Hello.
That was the saddest little hello.
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 Hi, everybody. Boy, welcome.
Fucking. Hey. It's fine.
The pre-show stuff, I swear, guys. If we could almost turn that into its own show.
This cool is on fire.
How many people have their pizza?
I've already eaten mine.
What?
I saved three slices. That's fair. That's fair.
I just have a ratatouille carbonara in the fridge, so I'll just have that later.
To be fair,
my name's Dan. I'm here to one up you.
Dan's like, what's this? You have pizza? I have upside down pizza.
I have ratatouille carbonara.
I have and 1,000 year aged prosciutto. And it was made of the meats of the most expensive pork.
I used Adonis himself's penis to batter the bread and the dough and then thus make the pizza. That's Dan.
I went to McDonald's.
Nice. Yeah,
that was good.
Since Mav is still not here yet, and I know you guys are wondering, like, what are you talking about? She's right there, Wack.
Mav's in traffic.
She's right there. Look, she's so
I
surprised
just saw
by the conversation. You know.
Send us a text?
No, the text on her picture.
Yeah.
You found do not return.
Yeah. I know what you guys are thinking. Yeah, Mav's not quite here yet. She's on her way. She's on her way. She had a bit of a mishap with her vehicle, and she didn't get into an accident. She's totally fine.
She lost.
So is the vehicle.
She did, however, lose said vehicle.
Yeah.
In the airport,
where she parked it herself.
Yeah.
This is why you always put a leash on your car.
I thought you.
Or just write down the number. You know,
put a leash on your map.
Put a leash on your map. There you go. Oh my god, dude! Do you know that they make like little like. Kid harnesses.
Yeah. I had one as a child.
Can we get one of those for Mav, please?
Oh my god, at like a con?
At TwitchCon. Yeah. Make her wear it at TwitchCon.
I had to wear one as a child because I was a dasher. I just ran.
Domestic dasher.
Yeah, no, like, my parents had to put one.
If we do
like,
a live
episode.
Because
I just run, I'd just be like, I'm leaving!
If we do the thing, we're gonna put a fucking leash on Mav.
Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah.
I'm really excited
you know
at the possibility of real life hellos. Like,
Whoa.
I'm super excited for like maybe hearing Mav say that in real life. TwitchCon's gonna be great.
Mav actually she must have inspired me before the show because since everybody was on this pizza kick, I went to go pick my pizza up and. I got it, and I had this old couple start talking to me. They're like, how's the pizza inside? Oh, it's really good, you know, blah, blah, blah. Bullshit. Have my pizza on top of the car.
What?
Get into the car.
No!
The pizza on top of the car. Start to pull out.
What?
This woman runs out frantic from the pizza place. Oh, my God! She's like, she's pointing up on top of the car. A kid knocks on my window. I'm like, wow. I was like, holy shit, they got this covered. They got the double.
Wow.
You're
not the first person to do that, is what that says.
Yeah. I think I remember, like, back in high school, I had this. It was that one kid on a sports team who was like, he would just show off at anything that he was even remotely competent at. And he had a car. It was a car. And he's like, it's the manual. It's so fast. And it drove me nuts. One day, he had all of his books. I mean, a stack of, like, we're talking like 6 books. And he had it on top of his car and he gets in there and he goes, see you nerds later. And I swear to God, said it like that, gets into his car and peels out and his books just turn into a cloud. Whoa! Oh, it feels so good.
I feel like that little kid outside of Wax Pizza Shop has paid like 3 shekels a day just sit there and wait. And then, like, it just, he's
where
like,
where do you live, Wack? Are you in Israel? Like, what the fuck?
Wack lives in Ravenloft. Like, he just lives in Ravenloft.
I live in New York. No, if it was Ravenloft, it wouldn't be pizza. It wouldn't be pizza.
By yourself.
Some of the kids in Ravenloft are real. Like, why, like, all of the children in Ravenloft are terrifying, but also slightly see-through. So, you know.
Why?
Only
why
mildly guys, worrisome.
Can we not talk about Hawaiian pizza in the
yeah, how about we don't?
Thank you very much.
That was delicious.
Yeah, yeah, let's not. Pizza.
That's basically an affront to humanity.
No. No, it wasn't. No. And your saltiness towards said Hawaiian pizza is fueling my DM powers right now.
You know, Wack, I've always loved Hawaiian pizza. There's nothing, there's actually nothing better.
We've got 1 foot in the grave right now.
Let me tell
you.
You
know what?
Fuck you.
You look today?
Fuck you,
Wack. Seriously.
You can't even affect me.
It works today.
I'm already fucked. You can't affect me. What I've, Wack doesn't realize, like, I'm playing the long con here. There is a long con that he does not know about, okay? And he might think he knows about it now. That is the long con. Right there. Hold on. I actually have something to match this. You thought? You looked up. You know, it's really sad how well that fits on your
head. You're about to be captured by Money Shot, and that's your long con. You are on fucking par, sir.
Good. You're practicing. That's where you want to be.
That face is how Richard just feels and exists, by
like
the
perpetually
way.
Perpetually just...
just...
Yeah, it's gonna be hard when you actually.
He's sick of his shit.
I don't know.
Richard is gonna have to get his when he eventually gets his cyberware face installed. Oh, gonna have man. To get that setting set up. So
that's if he lives,
yeah.
But yes, absolutely. Just resting. I'm sick of your shit face. And that's Boom, apparently.
Gentleman Boom.
There it is.
This is Gentleman Boom.
Oh, yes. Where's my sign? I do still have my sign.
Oh, my God.
Oh, there we go. Maestro!
Corn?
Can I kick off this session?
Yes. Whack. Oh, yes, please.
You're fucking...
Whack.
Oh, God.
Don't put that in your mouth!
That's not how you...
No, you're supposed to yell. Oh, I'm sorry. Jay doesn't know how to use a didgeridoo, but let's not tell him.
Just get a paper towel roll, like Jay. It's a fucking cheaper version of the same thing.
How did turn a screamer into a Wookiee?
That's what an Alaskan bull moose sounds like when it's in heat.
Oh, man.
Poor Pip. Poor Pip. She's the only one providing estrogen to this group right now.
I feel super fucking out.
Right, but like, let's be honest here. When Mav's here, it does it's not anything.
It's not estrogen. Mav's version of estrogen is like mutated and warped.
It's
fucking. Wow. Mav comes in like, let's go shopping before I run us off a cliff. And then there she goes.
What?
She's like, Brenda, oh my God, isn't this such a funny troll?
Everyone's dead! What the fuck? Lol, KK, LOL, smiley face. Like,
speaking of everyone's dead, should we give like a little bit of a recap of last session?
No.
Should we just remind people what happened?
No.
Boom is boom.
Nope.
Well, see how much longer.
Because it didn't go super great last session. Did it, guys?
Well, let's be honest here. It wasn't ever going to go great.
Oh, no.
Wait, no.
I feel like...
We didn't roll that well. True. However...
No, you rolled really badly.
Right. However...
We'd have been fine. Better than we are now.
An insane set of odds right now. So, I don't know if we're ever going to win this.
You okay there? What the fuck was that?
I just listen. What happens when Wack takes us to the dark place?
That reminded me of that.
There was an errant pineapple chunk on that piece of pizza. That's what happened.
It's just tomatoes and spinach and mushrooms and lepepe.
Oh, you did the mushrooms too.
Oh, yeah.
I like that our pizza taste is like in line, Jay.
I just got a pizza with just every kind of meat there is.
Yes. Like, that is the correct kind of pizza.
You disgust me.
Chicken bacon white sauce. Chicken bacon white sauce.
Also, yeah, that work, yeah.
No, I'm not a big bacon guy, so I try to avoid it.
I wanted to eat
ham, chicken ham white sauce.
That's true. Ham is good. I like turkey bacon. I don't like regular bacon.
I like turkey bacon as well.
Have you ever had artichoke, fettuccine artichoke pizza?
Yes. Artichokes and fettuccine and pizza separately. So
No. You
motherfuckers, I'm trying to do a recap here.
Oh yeah, sorry! I totally forgot!
No! Fuck it!
Alright, everyone mute. Serious faces. Serious faces. Right?
We start talking, we're like, yeah, we're gonna do roleplay now, and everybody's serious. And then it drifts. And then it goes too far.
No, this is not just this group, okay? This happens all the time. To every group.
We're getting it out of our system now, alright?
Yeah. To be fair, in my other groups I get told off, so it's quite nice to be able to do it in here and not be told off. Thank you for not telling me off on a regular basis.
I don't
Whoa!
Have to.
You wanna fucking go?
You want me?
You want?
Speaking of Pip, would you be so kind as to join us on Roll 20?
Yes. Am I not logged in?
I don't think so.
Okay. Nope. I'm up to go.
It would have been sad if Mav beat you to it. That would have been a life achievement. A negative life achievement. So let's do a bit of a recap here as to what happened last episode. There were a lot of things that happened last episode, not a lot of them good for the group. The group, of course, learned their lesson from the first mission and decided, hey, we're going to spend some time doing some legwork. We're gonna prep really hard for this mission. We're going to get like set up and good. Everything's great. We're the best. And, they did that. They did that. They were set up really well for the mission. And then when it came time to actually do the mission, didn't go according to plan so much. They sort of set up a plan where they wanted to have the convoy that they were trying to hijack get pulled over by some Secura cops. And, well, it didn't work so well. The cops pulled over the whole convoy, and the APCs that were guarding it didn't separate, because why the fuck would they? That's their job. So they killed the cops that were trying to separate them because they suspected that something was up. And that's when everything went to hell. Voss had the shot lined up and whiffed hard.
Everyone has an update.
Sending a lot of angry, large caliber bullets her way. She took a little bit of damage, fell off the billboard that she was on, trying to shoot out some of the tires for the convoy. It all just went further and further downhill from there. After seeing the shot was missed, Boom hopped into an SUV and decided to go head on into a heavily armored vehicle.
Correction. Boom decided to go boom.
Sure. Correction. I was just translating. I was translating. So Boom went head on into an APC. It didn't work out so well for his, you know, for his whole this didn't work out well. He took some damage. The APC decided to follow up, and somebody popped out and went after him, sort of woozy and not making great decisions. Boom decided to hop out of the SUV, and in doing so got shot in the back, getting knocked unconscious. While that was going on,
he dead. I saved.
Nope.
Not yet.
No dead.
He dead.
While that was going on,
Richard hopped in the DeLorean and went back in time to try and straighten things out. he's with a helpful volunteer by the name of Roadkill, their driver.
Monica, you figured out Cyber yet?
Her souped up our souped up DeLorean trying to chase after the convoy. It also didn't go great. Richard decided to tinker with a gas grenade inside the car while he was chasing after them, hoping to rig it to explode. I think you crit failed the roll, if there was such a thing as a crit fail. I think it was a double one.
It was a one and a three, I think.
Oh, okay.
So it ended up being like a five total, but it was bad.
Like I think we only had like one or two successes.
I had a success very early on. And
if
that
they
was,
were a success, like, I
rolled
one,
a 13.
One roll that Voss got, that was an 11.
That it I think that was to cling to the billboard.
That was to not fall and die.
But you dropped your gun, right? Or was that another?
No, that was a different one. Time.
That was the bad roll the second
time. That was a bad roll the second
time. I have to throw this out there real quick. For anyone watching on YouTube and for anyone that doesn't bother to pay attention to the chat on Twitch, my shit's lagging like a motherfucker. So either the stream looks like shit or we lag. You just bear with us. We'll get her done. Sorry, there we go.
It's all Mav's fault.
It is.
Mav's fault.
So,
comment section. So healthy. If you feel the hashtag blame Mav. Thank you.
Richard chased after with the DeLorean, and the grenade went off in his hand. The gas grenade filled up the car with gas, forcing them to careen off the road.
We didn't crash. We didn't crash, and we didn't take harm.
Correct. And so you basically careened off to the side, and you had to stop the car and open up the doors, get the gas out.
I thought we were still driving.
Mm-mm.
Oh
no! You said you pulled off.
Yeah, you said.
Oh
you,
yeah, well, you, okay, all right, fair enough.
Yeah. So at that point, it was all up to. It's all up to Mav.
Because she was in an SUV.
Hey, Mav, how you gonna get us out of the pit? Oh, wait!
Jen had an idea to use her comms to try and jam the communications for the convoy. Maybe disrupt the communications between the APCs and the convoy, only to find out that the convoy is AI-controlled. She got some nasty feedback and also careened off the side of the road while the convoy sailed off. Boom, laying unconscious and bleeding out on the ground, was then approached by some old acquaintances.
Mom? Dad?
The group called Money Shot, the porn star hit squad of SenseX. And I think we're going to start things off there. Because Simon, you were sort of still off to the side of the road. You basically had no ride. You were just kind of watching this all unfold.
I am not too far away from Voss. And I have no vehicle. And basically useless at this point.
Simon's that dude in the middle of every like Need for Speed race that throws down the flags and then gets left behind.
He's just like, oh fuck, now I gotta
and they
walk.
All start running and driving. Yeah.
Yeah. It's like a 2-mile race. Shit.
Yeah. Yeah. It's not a great situation by any means. So this group is approaching Boom.
Yep.
And out from the car comes this sort of android-like robot that's quite shapely, to say the least. I feel like I'm almost envisioning, like, what's her name from Mass Effect?
Oh, Edie?
Yeah,
I have a picture of what I said Elena was, if you want it.
I think you put it up on the.
I did send it.
You put it on tweet, right?
I put it up on the tweet. I'll throw it in the chat there as well. That is, yeah. I don't know if I can. I can't.
Oh yeah, it was in the tweet today. Yeah.
It was the one in the tweet. So that's what I imagine her looking like.
It's a naughty bot.
Yeah. So, Money Shot is basically surrounding Boom Boom at the moment. And you're unconscious. Okay. Yeah, you're out. Yeah, that's basically what happens when you fall to zero.
Yeah.
So, Simon, you can see all this. You can see Boom Boom getting surrounded by Money Shot. Do you do anything?
Just quick clarification. I'm not there, so never mind.
Yeah, I just have the car there. Don't use the map for like relative positioning.
Sure.
Oh. How far away are they?
From you, Simon, I'll say probably like 250 feet. Somewhere around there.
Okay.
I love watching Jay try to do math.
Oh, no, I'm doing production.
Okay. I'm going to hit recording on my glasses, which I can throw the glasses on. I won't melt. I throw that jacket on.
My immersion.
Yes, it is. It's really hot, but then Seattle people don't have AC.
Yeah. Oh, so same as us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
I think it's in the 30s Celsius for them.
It was 32 today.
Yeah. Mm. Yep. It's raining.
Hey, Jay, do me a favor. Just fucking suck on a dick. That would be great. Just Money Shot's going to give you one, though. So you're good. You're ready. You're solid. Sorry, I'm salty. I fucking hate this weather. all right. Anyway, so I hit recording on the glasses, and I want to be just observing, and I want to start making my way up to the bridge to Voss. I'm going to go to Voss. And as I'm moving, I'm kind of like a little bit of a jog, and I'm looking the other way. I'm like, this is Simon Frost.
Do we just see like this, like?
What?
it's all scribbly.
Oh no!
I was just saying, like Simon from around the corner is like.
Oh no! I'm out in the open. I'm on my way. The caravan's gone. I'm on my way up to Voss. I'm out in the open, just running towards her. Like all right, this, and I'm making sure to not record to swing and face her. I'm just grabbing a little bit of shot, a little bit of footage from what the fuck is going on in there. This is Simon Frost. Reporting in that there seems to be an altercation of some sort on the highway out here. What highway are we on, by the way? Or does it matter?
You
named it.
I can't remember. It's a fucking number, Jay.
The 701 or something.
It was the E80.
All right. Reminds me of old I-80 in Iowa. Wow, long time past. Anyway, this is Simon Frost reporting in. We've got some sort of an altercation on the highway on E-80, out in the middle of God, nowhere. It seems to be that there is a group of individuals, and if I can, and I have magnification on these, so I zoom in and I focus in. Do they have anything like showing or saying anything about like Money Shot?
Oh, their gear is ostentatious. This is like publicity for them.
Gotcha. Oh, fuck.
You know what I mean? Like they probably advertise themselves like in various gangbangs and shit, like Money Shot fucking gangbang 12, and you know what I mean? Like
they're on action films.
Yeah.
All right. So it seems to be that Money Shot has stopped the traffic on the highway, a high-speed highway, stopped the traffic, and they've gotten out of the car, and that appears to be some sort of a... Is that an android? Some sort of a robotic, humanoid, bipedal figure? I'm not quite sure what it is, but it's out there, and they're approaching somebody who has been injured on the road! I don't know what they're going to do next, but I'll be sure to be covering it. Simon Frost! Reporting for Channel Q. More information soon. And stop recording.
Nice.
Continue to make my way to Voss to try to, and then now I'm just fucking hauling ass. Like,
Okay.
What the camera angle? Ah!
So I feel like Voss is further away from them. So you're going the opposite direction because she was long range with the sniper rifle.
Wait, so she was supposed to be on the bridge over the road.
No, she was on a billboard. She was on a billboard.
No, I was on a billboard up to the side.
Oh.
So where you were underneath the bridge, you've had to come out. And now you've got to go further back to be able to reach where I've fallen down.
How far away is she? Sorry, I thought she was right there. How far away is she?
I would say she's probably like... maybe like 150 feet away from you. Sort of like on an angle. Almost like a really obtuse triangle.
Okay. There's nothing I can do for Boom. I continue to run to her.
Okay. So I feel like, you know, when you got your magnification, basically the way that these people looked, there was a man that quite obviously had some sort of like strange cod piece. And a woman with just the biggest tits you've ever seen in your life. Like, if you take the woman now that has like the biggest breast implants in the world, probably go up like another size. Just she's got some kind of weird cyber attachment so she can stay upright.
So you're telling me she's got the biggest in the world and also the strongest lower back muscles.
It's cybernetically enhanced.
Both of them have a cyber. They come as a package, right? Okay, got it.
Yeah. It's a cybernetically enhanced lower back to get. She's got to like lower her center of gravity somehow. and there are basically a super tanned like male and female with blonde hair, super tanned. They look like Hulk Hogan with like platinum blonde hair, like fucking super tan, covered in like chest grease. One of them has a cyber deck. They have like a keyboard out that they're basically using.
Cyber deck. Oh.
What do you think I meant with the guy with the cod piece, my friend?
Is that the cyber deck that he's just like in his crotch? Just...
Hey, can we ask about that one instead, please? Can we ask about that one instead? Maybe that one made me feel
It hasn't been activated just yet. Give it a minute.
All right.
Gross.
A minute?
So there's another woman that's like that looks like a dominatrix a lot less clothing the robot itself sort of like is very like herky jerky in its movements, you know, it's like you know, like it looks like any of the if you guys have watched like any of like the attempts at love bots. Oh. They're really creepy. They're super super creepy.
No! Yeah. Not, please.
Yeah, it's a more evolved version of that, but you know, it's still very awkward.
Is it like C-3PO kind of movement?
Yeah.
Yeah,
pretty much.
The boobs jiggle.
Yeah.
C-3PO with boobs.
Did they program the boob physics?
C-3DDPO.
So these people surrounding, and you can basically you saw like the logo on the robot like imprinted like just above the breast, and it said. Cyber love intimacy toy. Give him a minute.
Are you fucking
serious? Wow. Okay.
That's what they called me in high school.
acronyms.
Oh yeah.
Oh wait, I missed the acronym. What was it again?
Cyber love intimacy toy.
It spells penis, I get it.
Yeah, and it also had quite clearly featured like a self-washing and lubricating love optimization wizard.
What is it, like Clippy or something? Like,
just... Oh. I see you're having trouble getting it up.
Would you like help?
Caroline actually named that one Jay.
Oh, of course she did! That's why I love her. Oh, man.
If you want in on this action, don't forget that WAC does DM prep streams that you can help affect. Like, name shit like this.
Yes. So she basically is standing like right above Boom. And one of the guy that's sort of like all tan and looks like a super young like Hulk Hogan and covered in like chest oil walks up with the cyber deck. He sort of like sets it down on the ground and starts like furiously typing. And he says,
whoa, I don't believe it. He does have her. I was right.
What do you mean?
I mean, Elenap. He's got it installed.
That idiot. He should have known how bad it would fuck with his brain. Can you download her?
I think so. I'm going to do it right now.
Furiously tacking away on the keyboard. Boom. You start to like violently shake. And, and the guy with the cod piece, says,
all right, throw him in the car. Let's bag him.
All right. So, boom, they grab your feet as the keyboard's clacking away, and you're just kind of like having almost like a seizure. And then he says,
got her. She's in.
And you can see like the android just kind of like.
Oh, we're orgasming together.
And then like the eyes just like blink rapidly. And then like. Different like panels and shit open up, and you can see like this sort of like the hair colors like changes, and she start like an outfit just kind of shoots out from nowhere on this android. So like the cyber skin or whatever like sort of flushes a little bit, and it starts to look a lot more human. You can still see like the logo like just above the breast, and she starts like looking a lot more like a person. And you can see like the guy with the cyber deck like walk over.
Elenap? Elenap, are you ready to receive commands?
I hate this guy just for his voice.
And she says,
Daddy!
She like, she blinks and she jiggles like unnecessarily. Like it's just...
She blinks and her boobs like, woo!
She does like the beach volleyball, the dead or alive beach volleyball. Well, like,
where they like flick their finger and their boobs go.
Yeah. It's totally unnecessary. So, yeah, they start to walk Boom over to the car, and they throw Boom inside. Voss.
Yes.
What the hell is going on with you at this point?
So... Do I see that happen?
Yeah, I'd say you do.
Yeah, I'm going to scream as loudly as I can, and I'm going to peg it in that direction, even if it's like... Even if it's the most futile thing, because I can't get onto this road. I'm going to scream as loudly as I can. It's not going to be anything coherent. It's just going to be a scream, and I'm just going to peg it in that direction and try and get there. I mean, I'm not going to. There's no way I can catch them now that they're getting in a car, but...
Motorcycles, right?
Several of them have motorcycles. Three of them have motorcycles, and then there's also a car.
Oh, okay.
That's where Elena came from, and the...
Oh, right, okay.
The glazed brother and sister pair.
Sorry, he's insulting my language again. like, my first language is Welsh, and he's having a little crack again, and I just can't. yeah, no. I'm just gonna scream. I'm just gonna scream, and I'm gonna peg at that road, because they can't.
The best part is, this is probably like almost like a PUBG kind of situation for you, Simon, because you're like hauling ass towards where you saw Voss, and then she just hops up, and she just starts like hauling ass towards you. It's like...
Wait, you're running or shooting?
Running.
She's running. Oh, screaming. You're running.
She didn't pick up her gun.
What? No. No, that's back there on the road.
What are you doing?!
They've got him! They're gonna take him away!
What are we gonna do?
I don't know!
We can't go after them like
you
this!
Turn around and run!
There's nothing we can do,
Turn around and run!
There is nothing that this will accomplish! We can go and try to get him later! But this isn't going to do anything! We have to leave! We have to go for Boom!
He was gonna kill himself because I was hurt, like, just...
We have to go. We can't do anything for him here.
Okay. What do we?
Get your gun. Go get your gun. Okay.
Okay.
We need to find Richard. Mm-hmm. And we need to figure out what the hell is up with Jen. And we need to regroup if we have any hope of getting Boom back.
This is more important than this stupid fucking trick.
That's fine. We're getting Boom back. We'll get him back, Voss. And at this point, like, we're next to each other, and I'm just, like, holding on to him. Like, we'll get Boom back! I promise!
Wait, okay. I'm gonna turn away and walk back and start, like, pulling my gun apart and trying to put it in the bag and trying to move.
You gotta find your gun. Go ahead and give me an assess roll. Let's have you do the assess move to see if you can figure out where the fuck you threw your gun.
Shit.
Edge.
Yep.
Ooh. Well, there's a good roll.
Hey, 13. Wow. You totally know exactly where it was. Let's see. What kind of questions you get to ask me?
Where's the fucking gun?
Because like, I feel like your perception is like maxed out right now. Because of the adrenaline.
Yeah.
So go ahead and you get to ask me three questions from that list based on the current situation.
Oh, three?
Three.
Oh.
Well, technically, girl. You have three hold.
Right.
And you get to take +1 forward when acting on the answers.
Where can I gain the most advantage?
Where can you gain the most advantage? It depends on what... where you're trying to get the advantage and what situation here, because I feel like you've got two situations.
I've got to find my gun first.
I'm going to assume that with that high of a roll, you find it, but you're sort of like checking out the whole situation. So you can ask me a question about your situation.
Cool. Okay.
So you've got the Boom situation and you got the convoy situation.
Yeah, no, fuck the convoy.
Okay.
Really quickly, like, the convoy is just... You'd said the convoy is gone.
Well, the convoy is... It's heading
its way out.
Yeah. Okay. It's a bus, man. It's not... It can't accelerate that fast.
Right, yeah. But Richard and
heavily
Jenna
armored
are off
bus.
Out of it, right?
Yeah.
They're off after it.
Yeah.
Right. So
they've gone off-roading. They're basically like...
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about Richard. Sorry. Yeah, yeah.
Richard and Jen. Yep. They both fucking careened off.
So they've got that. That's fine. The whole situation with Boom is the most important one right now.
Okay. So how do you gain the most advantage with the situation with Boom? I think if you can disable the car, that's definitely the best advantage. Because they threw Boom into the car. That's where Elena, the Elena bot went. And the two greased up Hulk Hogan looking peoples.
Okay, how is the car vulnerable to me?
It looks like a big fucking luxury car. It looks like it's very flashy, but it definitely doesn't have a lot of armor.
What potential complication do I need to be wary of?
If you go after the car, you're gonna probably lose the convoy.
Totally a worse outcome than that, too.
Those two have got the convoy, though, right? They've got the convoy.
Nobody has the convoy.
Hey, you don't mind having your head smushed, right? Because you're telling me Boom's more important than your head fucking blowing up right now.
Okay, out of character, are we in character deciding this right now, or are we talking? Like, what is...
Yeah, talk in character.
Why not?
Right.
You're telling me he's more important. I can shoot the shit out of that car, and we can try somehow to get...
The convoy is gone. The convoy is gone.
We have to trust in the other two now to pull that through. You wouldn't have brought them together if you didn't think they could do something. This is you. You brought these people to us. You know that.
If you take a shot at the car, and let's say you do disable it. What are we going to do about the other three? If you want to act recklessly, I can't stop you. You know I can't stop you.
While this is going on, I think let's pause on this high tension situation because we need to find out what's going on with Richard. Richard, you got back into the DeLorean.
We never left it. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, but you guys had to clear out, sort of fan the gas out of the fucking car.
Yeah.
Cause, I mean, it's tear gas. You guys are all like welled up. Your eyes are burning.
Yeah. Yeah.
Throats are burning. And you're probably realizing, like, just how much of your body is still meat, right? Like, because of this pain.
It's pissing Richard off. Yeah. Me. It's pissing me off.
Yeah.
Roadkill. How much do you want to complete this fucking job? I want my money. So do I. Go after them. I have an idea, and it's a really fucking bad one, but I'm pretty sure you Steel mean like- might kill me anyway if I don't fucking get this, so let's do it!
You mean like tinkering with a grenade in the car?
Something like that, but probably fucking worse.
Alright, hop in. Hop in.
I get in the driver's side back seat again.
Okay.
All right. I want you to pull up next to the doors of the bus.
Okay.
She's still like coughing. She hits the fucking gas, and unlike a real life DeLorean, the car starts and it goes.
Thank
you. Oh, yeah, this is a souped up DeLorean. It has like an actual real life engine in it. not whatever fucking tin cannon string they use in the real ones. The car fucking guns. There's just like dirt and shit and grass spinning up. As you guys are like off-roading, the car is like fishtailing like all over the fucking dirt. You guys are just leaving this like horrible mess behind you. And she just goes right back onto the road. And she probably still leaves like that like Back to the Future kind of noise in the DeLorean. So that's still like,
hell yeah,
keyed
hell
up, yeah, you know?
Yeah.
And you take off down the strip. You can see like, she's just like cutting in and out through the traffic. Probably cutting it like this close to the central guardrail.
Yeah.
You can see it like whizzing past, like, and like holding the horn down occasionally, like spinning back into the traffic. Ahead of you, you can see that the APCs have moved back into their formation with one behind and one in front of this convoy. And she says, "All right, what do we do?"
"I'm gonna try to open that door and get inside that fucking bus. I'm gonna need you to try and keep us alive with those damn APCs in front and back. We might have some cover if you're just next to it."
Is there a middle door on the bus like a standard city bus, or is it like a school bus that only has a front door?
Give me a D2. One is yes, two is no.
Okay. Two is no. Okay, only as a front.
The bad rolls continue. So
I mean, and there's still like, it's a big bus, like, and that would actually only make us in view of one of the APCs potentially versus two. So that's not necessarily a bad answer.
All right, get me in as close as you can. I've got,
and he starts pulling out from his, from my cyber arm, just cabling, for bypass to jack into the fucking door.
I'm gonna plug in. If you need to pull away,
how
I've
are
got
we gonna
enough-
get past the APCs? You're gonna try and jack in while there's APCs there? Are you crazy?
A little bit. If you need to, you can hit the brakes to go back a bit, just so we don't get shot. I've got enough cable
for a little
bit
of
that.
I think the closer we get to that convoy, the safer we are.
I agree.
So you see her, like, she probably, like, looks over her shoulder, and you see, like, a big fucking smile on her face, and just, like, the craziest look in her eye.
That's what I want! Oh.
And she's just like, she's tapping the steering wheel, like, she's like getting psyched up, ready for this.
Keep us alive, Roadkill. Don't live up to your name.
Let's do this! And she fucking, she spins the tires, and you guys are already going like fucking like 70 miles an hour.
Jesus. So,
yeah. Oh, yeah. She's got a serious engine in this fucking thing.
I'm gonna die.
And you just get like slammed back, like into the back seat, like just. And you start taking off towards the APCs. Now, I don't roll for her. I don't do that. That's not the way that the mechanics work here. So, she automatically does her job really well.
Oh.
That's the whole thing with this.
Yes! Thank you, Steel! Oh, thank you so much, Jack Donaghy of the future!
You've got Steel. So...
I do!
So the car just fucking guns it. And the APC in the back, the fucking turret swivels towards you. And you could just see, like... You could see, like, the you see it, like, get, like, red hot for a second and, like... Poof, the fucking smoke shoot out. these huge fucking 50 cal bullets ripping into the asphalt as the car is like, aah! You get slammed into the side of the car from the centrifugal force, and just like you're knocked around. Are you
wearing
a seatbelt?
I did buckle my seatbelt. Okay. I did. I've made it apparent. I've always been buckling my damn seatbelt.
So, it's canon. So you're like, it's digging into you, like, like, because she is going hard on this. Car is just swerving, smacking into the cars in the other lane, and just like, ding! And the DeLorean, like, is just avoiding these fucking shots. And she, like, goes, okay, we're going in! Like, slams into the fucking bus. The bus, like, slams to the left a little bit and kind of like smacks back into the car, like it's trying to push it away. I would like you to make a act under pressure, please.
9.
Okay.
Does it get a bonus from roadkill being a fucking god?
No.
Absolutely not. 9 isn't horrible.
Nine is okay.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
It's okay.
So, on a 9, when you race against the clock, act while in danger or act to avoid danger. Roll cool. On a 7 to 9, you stumble, hesitate, or flinch. The MC will offer you a worse outcome, hard bargain, or ugly choice. Okay.
It's about as ugly as it gets already, so...
She's basically saying, I can't get any closer! You hear like the 50 cal shooting and the car swerves again. She keeps like bobbing and weaving, so she's like getting close to the convoy, but she can't really get close. You're gonna have to lean out of the car.
All right.
Don't slam me into the bus, roadkill.
I'm gonna try.
And, like,
woo!
Like, leans out of the car window with arm out, holding the cable.
Okay. You're trying to, like, get this sorted right now, and get the cable, like, plugged into some jack in the door. But there's an APC firing. You got to make another act under pressure roll.
Oh, this is the roll of your life.
Yeah! I'll fucking take it. Yeah.
So, roadkill swivels. Go, go. You like immediately jump out of the fucking window. And how do you do this?
This is with my cyber arm that I'm trying to plug it in, because cyber arm's left arm. Grab that little handle that's like the little like bracing handle inside the car, and just lean out as far as I can and just jam that in, like right where the lock would normally be on the door. And then pull myself back into the car before like it clipped by some sort of debris.
Okay. Yeah, like as soon as the car gets like super close to the convoy again, the APC stops shooting. So like it's the car is like right up on the fucking convoy. And you just have time to jack in. While this is going on, why don't we swing back to the other group?
Yeah. All right, I need a drink.
That was fucking awesome.
Voss, you yes. And Simon. What's yeah. going on? How are you doing this?
Okay.
So, how good can I see this trooper vehicles? What can I see from where I am, like, right now?
The trooper vehicles?
The troop of.
You
said there were several. So there's the car.
Money shot, guys.
Yeah. They're basically looking to like make a U-turn right now. They're trying to find the break in the guardrail to sort of make a U-turn. I'd say we can carry over your assess roll from before. I'd say you still have vision of them, because that was your main thing, and you have a plus one forward when acting against them.
Okay. Yeah, fuck it. I'm gonna try and shoot every goddamn vehicle that I can see, but at tire level rather than at window level. I'm fucking terrified of killing Boom if I flatten the cars.
Oh god.
With them making a U-turn,
they're gonna be exposed wide.
Yeah. Have I got enough?
I'm also going to help with this.
Have I got enough time to
How
link
are you helping?
My rifle? Can I lean on you to steady my shot?
You've got a leg for that.
There's a leg for that.
I don't know how to use that yet.
I'm gonna say you don't have enough time to jack into your rifle.
Okay.
This is a very hurried situation.
Bad decision, and just be like, whatever you need to help you make this shot, I am here for it.
Okay. So first, Voss, explain how you're trying to take this shot. How are you setting up here with Simon?
All right. Can I see better from higher up?
Of course.
You have barely any time.
No, I mean, like, how tall is Simon?
Oh, my God.
Worst idea, NA.
Oh, God.
Simon, you fucked up, dude.
Oh, God. And I thought I was in danger.
Does it
help? Simon doesn't know. I don't know anything about military, anything like that.
I don't care how tall are you.
I'm 6'1". Wow, why?
Well, I have a better shot from being, like, 6 foot further up in the air.
Not a lot.
Okay, cool. That's fine. In that case, I'm going to break my rifle out, and I'm gonna pop it into the crook of my shoulder in the hope that I can pull it, and I'm going to get him to stand behind me with one hand on the small of my back and one hand behind my shoulder and just press.
Okey-doke. Voss,
Don't lock your elbows. Like, bend your elbows, otherwise I'm going to send your elbows back through the rest of your body.
They're bent!
Yep.
Voss, make your mix it up, please.
This is meat, not synth now, yeah? Balls. Do I get a forward on that?
You do get a forward. And Simon, you're going to also roll your help, which is plus your links with Voss.
Okay.
I add one in for forward, right? Because you have a link.
We're lagging just a little bit.
Just be able to roll your link.
Don't make the roll.
Yeah, you just roll your link.
Okay, we're good. Make the roll.
Simon, but I get one forward on the meat roll, yeah?
You get one forward on the meat roll. Simon just gets a regular links roll.
Right, even though I have a link with Voss, right?
That's your role.
Right. Okay. Perfect. All right. Come on.
I'm dead.
Yes.
Ooh!
Yes.
There's a 10.
Okay.
So, Voss, we need your roll.
That's assistance.
I don't want to roll. I'm really scared.
Do it. Do it.
Oh. Oh.
That's a 12. That's a 12 plus Simon. Yeah. Oh, wait, Simon. Are you trying to hinder her or help her?
No.
Sabotage.
It wouldn't matter. It wouldn't actually change anything.
Of course I'm trying to help her, whack!
Well, the reason that I ask is because you have a very interesting directive, don't you?
Oh, my God. Don't.
That's not the directive.
Oh, no, that's for Genevieve. That's
correct.
For Genevieve.
Oh, my God.
Never mind.
Oh, believe me. I read over my directives before this happened.
So, okay. So,
Dr. Holy shit!
You hear the sound of her rifle powering up, and Simon, you could feel Simon shaking as he's holding you on, like, holding your back.
Can I be asking him to fucking stop and to stay still?
Because like, your rifle is going, making that familiar. And the fucking tires all blow out, just fucking shatter the whole rim and everything off of these motorcycles and the luxury car, just bracka, 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 doom, doom, doom. Ooh. And probably, if, and I want to say the cars that are on the road are just like spinning out of the way. You probably send several of them crashing, creating this like massive fucking pileup. And all the fucking cars start to spin. You can see that the three people on the motorcycles just go fucking flying. Like the motorcycles like totally dump sideways and just go sliding off to the road, to the side of the road. The luxury car smacks into the guardrail, like just screeching the paint across the guardrail. And blowing out Jay's eardrums, which is a mad bonus. the car's like just like comes to a stop. You hear like from like the sound of like the rim is basically like half shattered. So it makes like a few rotations and then it just slides. And the doors for the car open up, and I think that's where we're gonna take our first break.
Oh! Oh! Holy shit! How are we alive? So far with the redemption rolls. Oh my god!
Yeah, we're gonna
hands down. We fucking got this.
We'll be fucking shit. Fuck.
Tweet this out. Good god!